Bangladesh's economy is booming and it's even outperforming others in South Asia. The country, which was once called a basketcase, is now being termed as the new Asian tiger. A UN report says its economy will continue to expand at a rapid pace. Bangladesh has been averaging an annual growth of more than 6%. Its GDP rose from over $100 billion in 2009 to almost $250 billion in 2017. That's a massive 150% increase. So how did Bangladesh get here? The garment manufacturing industry is big business here. Bangladesh is the second largest apparel exporter in the world after China. 80% of its exports and up to 15% of its GDP comes from this. But the government is making efforts to diversify and expand the economy. It is now emerging as a pharmaceutical hub, which is estimated to be worth over $5 billion by 2023. Other industries like aquaculture and IT are also flourishing. Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina has also pushed for Digital Bangladesh to become an emerging player in the technology sector. Bangladesh owes much of this progress to microfinance initiatives made by NGOs like Grameen Bank and BRAC. Loans to small-scale entrepreneurs has helped millions of people, especially women. Grameen Bank founder Mohammed Yunus even won a Nobel Peace Prize for his work. But these institutions have also been criticized for taking money from the poor, though they deny allegations. Bangladesh's government is also making significant strides in social development. There has been a major focus on women empowerment. Bangladesh invests in its women and girls and consistently outperforms its neighbors, India and Pakistan, on gender inequality measures. But there are criticisms and challenges. When it comes to the ease of doing business, Bangladesh stands at the lowest amongst South Asian nations. The government has also received flak for the health and safety conditions of garment factories, and garment workers have held demonstrations for a higher minimum wage. Experts also say that a lack of adequate infrastructure coupled with gas and power supply issues are hindering the country from reaching its true potential. And then there are other problems such as widespread poverty, unplanned urbanization, overpopulation, and poor governance. So can Bangladesh keep the momentum going?